Welcome back. Today we're experimenting with the sine wave generator and the available accessories. But first, a little background on waves. Did you know there are three kinds of waves? Transverse, longitudinal, and surface waves. Transverse waves are waves that move up and down, where the highest point is referred to as the crest, and the lowest point is known as the trough. Longitudinal waves have compressions and rarefactions, similar to a spring or slinky. The compression is the point where the particles are closest to each other, and rarefaction is the point where they are furthest away from each other. Lastly, in surface waves, particles at the surface of the medium move up and down, as well as back and forth. These waves are often referred to as circular waves. An important concept in studying wave behavior are standing waves. A standing wave is formed when the vibrational frequency of the wave source causes reflected waves from one end of the medium to interfere with incident waves from the source. In other words, if the frequency is just right, the reflected waves are in sync with the original wave and the wave looks like it's standing still. Now that we understand waves a bit better, we're going to begin our experiment by demonstrating standing waves first. To visualize standing waves, attach a string to the wave driver on one end and the other end to a stationary object. Now, turn on the wave generator. At first, you'll notice the string is moving, but there's no evidence of any constructive or destructive interference, and the string just sort of bobs around. Increase the frequency on the wave generator and you'll begin to see clear nodes and antinodes. Congratulations, you have created a standing wave. To visualize longitudinal waves, attach one end of the wave spring to the wave driver and the other end to a stationary object, such as a ring stand. Turn on the generator and begin by adjusting the frequency to a low value. Now you can see the crest and troughs of transverse waves forming in the spring as the generator oscillates. Here you can also see the compression and rarefaction in the spring. Another accessory to the sine wave generator are the metal resonance strips. These help students understand the relationship between the length of an object and its fundamental frequency. Each of the strips are a different length, and therefore will resonate at a different frequency. Begin by turning the generator to the lowest possible frequency. Slowly increase frequency until you see the longest strip begin to vibrate. Continue increasing the frequency, and the longest strip will stop resonating, and the next longest strip will begin. Next up is the resonance wire loop. This accessory is a fantastic way to help learners understand the wave behavior of particles. Attach the resonance wire loop to the generator and begin observing what happens at very low frequencies. At first, the loop is just shaking, but as you increase the frequency, you'll begin to see nodes and antinodes forming. A node is where the waves have no amplitude and the loop appears unchanged. Antinodes are where waves are at their highest amplitude and the loop appears stretched. When nodes and antinodes are achieved, this is resonance. And last, but certainly not least, are the Chladni plates. Ernst Chladni was a German physicist and musician. He's most well known for his work on vibrating plates and the nature of sound. He noticed how metal plates would vibrate and achieve resonance after applying a violin or cello bow. So how does this work? When salt or sand is scattered across the top of the plate, patterns become visible, revealing the sound waves, nodes, and antinodes. Turn on the sine wave generator and experiment with which frequencies produce resonance in the plate, and you'll see the sand begin to move into amazing patterns. So that's the sine wave generator experiment demonstrations. Thanks for joining us. Until next time, have fun learning.